said, I'm glad.
You know, people can make their own claims, but you have to see, where do you base your claims? Jesus presented that he was the Son of God because he was doing the will of the Father. Because what he was saying was everything that he heard from the Father. And he has said, if you don't want to believe me, look at
the words
John
that
the Baptist spoke about me. The Father testified to me, there was the voice, you know, from heaven during his baptism, that he is the beloved Son of God. If you don't want to believe me, look at my word, or my works. Believe my works, that I'm able to prove that I'm the Son of God. So Jesus also had to take pains to prove himself to be what he is. Now, Kipuloy says, I know the Son of God. What are his proofs? You just don't believe people because of what they say. That's why you have also to be discerning. What is his proof that he's a beloved Son of God? Did he do any miracle? Was there a testimony coming from God? No?
He is quoting in the scriptures also.
It's not only enough to quote the scriptures because, you know, you can find anything in the Bible. You can even prove that there is no God in the Bible.
Says the fool.
Because it's not just a matter, it's not only, the Bible does not speak by itself. We make it speak. So it depends on your bias. No? That's why Jesus has said, it's not only the Bible spoke about me, John the Baptist spoke about me, there was the voice coming from heaven, there was the works of Jesus to prove that he was the Son of God. Siya ano? No, ganun din yung ginagawa ng iba. They just use the Bible, but how did they use the Bible? Well,
thank you, sir.
Yes, yes.
In Exodus, it shows that God is a warrior. At tapos ay nakalagay pa doon, itinapon niya sa dagat ang kabayo at tawad. And then here is Jesus saying, God is compassionate. Paano natin, paano i-reconcile itong dalawang ito that God is a warrior and then God, at the same time, God is a compassionate Father.
Can you reserve that question this afternoon? Because we will have a special topic about the compassion of God. Mm. And the compassion of God is not only in the New Testament, but also in the Old Testament. Okay? So reserve that question. If it is not answered in that session, then you can ask. Okay?
Yes. Hi. I would like to thank you for a very beautiful presentation regarding the topics. Definitely, the looking at the past, the present, and towards the future, we see the beauty of the continuity, the wisdom, and the plan of God. My comment or my question also is, we also see here the universality of God's love, truly, that God wants to save everyone. God wants to bring everyone to Him. As you mentioned, it's not only for the chosen people. It's not only for the chosen race, but God came for all of us. But of course, as Christians, as Catholics, we hope to bring others to the faith. Can we safely say that it's enough that people follow their conscience? That they, in their own way, as long as they know that they are doing good, that they're doing what is right, that they do good and avoid evil, that they will be saved. And for this, Of course, there will always be the longing to bring them to confess Christ as truly their God. But for those who do not know God, truly, it's safe enough for us to say that they will be saved doing good.
Okay. First and foremost, we have this basic belief that Jesus is Savior. He is the only Savior. He is the only one who connects us with God. That's why even those people who don't recognize Jesus, if they are saved, they are saved by Jesus. They are saved by Jesus. Even the Muslims are saved by Jesus. So yan, basic sa atin yan. So whether you recognize him or not, if you are saved because of him. So in that case, bakit pa natin kailangan ipahayag siya? Why do we still have to proclaim him if they are saved naman by him? There is this duty for us first and foremost because this mandate is coming from Jesus himself. It's very clear in the New Testament, in the Gospels, and even in the Old Testament, in the letters, that we are to announce Him. So, it's because of that mandate, that command given to us. But then, we follow this command also because we believe that because of our faith, our life has been enriched. So it cannot be that we should only be enriched by ourselves. If this is only something that is good, we want to share. So we share, we want to make people Christians, not because we want to be dominate over them. No, but in order that they also can share in the goodness that we have received. So that's why I hope you value your being Christians. Because if you don't value your being Christians, so if you find it as a burden, why do you have to pass on the burden to the others? But if it is something good, you want to share it. That's why it is good news. So this is what the Pope, especially Pope Francis, is telling us. That we convince others by attraction. That's why the joy of the gospel, if you don't find joy in it, you will not attract people. No? So because we find joy in it, that's why we want to share it with the others. And even just by looking at us, by how happy we are as being Christians, then also they'll be attracted to it. Get it? No? And another one also, saved by your conscience, but we've also this, it's not only that you follow your conscience, you follow your right conscience. That's why the formation of conscience. We cannot just say, sinabi ng konsyensya mo, gawin mo yan. Tama ba yung konsyensya mo? Because we see that sin has affected our own conscience. So we have been broken. So our ideas have not been clear. Even our feelings are broken. That's why we have to continually educate people that have the right conscience. And as we have said, Jesus gives us is the way, the truth, and the life. He is the proper measure of everything. So it is right or wrong according to what Jesus said, according to what Jesus lived. Get it? Kasi kung sabi natin that anyway people are saved just by being good, then what's the point of God becoming man? Di pinabayaan niya na lang sana tayo. Besides, he became man in order to show us the way. So So he did not only forgive the sins, but because he could also forgive that from heaven. But he became man so that he can be an example, not only to teach us, just to teach us, we have the prophets who teach us already, but also sample how to live godly lives. How to live as God would have you live. And that's just the life of Jesus. Kaya may incarnation tayo. Anyway, nagsisimula pa lang tayo. But I always tell my students, natuturo pa rin ako ngayon. I always tell my students, if you don't have questions, you don't get answers. Now, if you want answers, give questions. And I would prefer to answer questions that you present rather than my own thoughts, because I don't know if my thoughts are important for you. But I'm sure your questions are important for you.
Yes.
So don't be ashamed to ask questions, afraid to ask questions. And also, we should have a critical mind. No, critical means investigative mind. Totoo ba yan? Paano ba yan? Why should we have a critical mind? In order that we can be more convinced. Don't just accept what I say. But you should be convinced. And if you are convinced, that means you have to dialogue with these ideas. So the critical mind is one that is dialogical. Able to understand so that you can own it. Kung sabi mo lang, okay lang, okay lang, okay lang. When the problem comes, you're not able to give answer because you have not really taken it seriously.
Sure. Sure, but I'm a professor in theology, an ex-seminarian, but now an atheist. So, kami, nag-list siya ng mga pangalan namin, and in-invite niya kami, the indoctrination. Saan ko ba't ganito pa? Saan ko nangyari? This is their discontinuity. The continuity of the discontinuity. So, paano po, paano nangyari? Naging atheist siya.
First and foremost, the faith is a gift. It's a gift. We cannot get it by ourselves. That's why you should value the gift. Thank the Lord for the gift of faith. It's not enough to be intelligent in order to be human. And that God gives His gift even to ordinary people, as what St. Paul was saying in 1 Corinthians. You were not, you didn't study, you are not noble, you are not wise, but God has chosen you. See, it's a gift. And secondly, faith, more than knowledge, more than knowing, is a relationship. Is a relationship with God. Is a relationship with Jesus. You can know many things about the person, but if you have no relationship with that person, you will not have faith. Kaya nga mahalaga yung prayer. No, because this is where our relationships are nurtured. Mahalaga yung sacraments. No? So, kaya hindi lang sapat na alam. Sometimes, in our catechetical ministry, we stress knowledge. But we don't give venues for relationships with God. Kaya kailangan din mag-create yung venue that they can relate with God. That's why you need to pray, you need to celebrate, you need to serve the poor. Kasama ng pag-develop ng faith niya. I remember clearly when I came from Don Bosco Victorias, and it was told to us that 1 year before I came, they have all this graduation, the honor in math, honor in religion, honor in language. The one who get the honor of fourth year in religion was a Chinese unbeliever. But he got the honor of religion because he was intelligent. He could answer all the questions. But he was not baptized. Okay, in danger that we just limit the catechism to knowledge.
I came from Zamboanga City, or Zamboanga Sibugay, wherein we have these brother Muslims. And actually, we had this so-called silsila, or dialogue with them. My question is regarding the jihad, or the holy war. Because for Muslims, jihad is justifiable because it's in, maybe it's in their Quran, or in the Old Testament. So as Christians, you there are some practices in the Old Testament that we did not adapt it anymore in the in our religion. So my question is, how can we possibly convince them that jihad is not a way to achieve peace?
We will not convince them.
Ang problema kasi ng mga Muslim, unlike us, we have the magisterium to teach us what is the right interpretation. That's why we are lucky as Catholics that we have the guidance of the Church to tell us what is the right way of understanding the Bible. Now, wala yan sa mga Protestante at wala yan sa mga Muslim. Recently, the Holy Father has gone to a university in Egypt, Al-Aqsa, Al-Qasar. Basta, this university, it must have been is the somehow the spokes is famous because its teachings are recognized by many in the Muslim world. Pero it's not even binding. So, ang kanya-kanyang imam, kanya-kanyang paniniwala. Kaya mahirap ma-explain sa kanila. I have read some interpretations that the jihad is first and foremost an internal struggle. It's a struggle to conquer yourself, not to conquer others. It's a war against yourself. Now, in that sense, it's related to what Jesus says, deny yourself. We have also in the teachings of the New Testament, especially in the Apostles, about the spiritual struggle, spiritual warfare. That's why you have the sword of the Word of God. You have the shield of faith. No, so, in this spiritual struggle, so it's also a struggle, but spiritual struggle, problema sa kanila, they put it as a struggle against others. But that's the only one interpretation. We cannot interpret for them. No? That's why we should value that we have the magisterium to teach us. Yung sinabi ko sa inyo, galing yan sa isang document ng simbahan about how to interpret the Bible in the church. And we have even a document about the Jewish and Christian interpretation of the Bible. So may mga bibigay sa atin ng gabay for the proper interpretation. Which address?
Yes. I just thought of these recent experiences, connecting it with discontinuity, continuity, regression or progression or whatever. The first happened end of March. I was with someone, a good soul, a good Catholic, coming from a good Catholic family. And she told me, don't worry, Father, I'll stick to my faith, I'll stick to the Catholic Church, I'll stick to Mama Mary. But allow me, or I let you know that I go to this Victory Fellowship. And the proclamation, the celebration is indeed very happy, very joyful. And the pastor really is very fiery, quoting from the scriptures left and right among others. Yeah, it dawned on me, yeah, catechism really has to make room for venue for relationship, not just for knowledge. I do not know kung saan po yun regression ba yun? Continuity, discontinuity. The second is, the second happened last April 29. I happened to be sitting beside Karen Davila. She was interviewing someone while we were watching something. And Karen Davila was telling me, "Hi, Father." Well, she recognized me. And she told me, "Father, I'm not a practicing Catholic. Well, I'm actually born again. But I let my son, who was with her, but I let her took his first communion just recently." And I thought, I asked myself, well, what's this inconsistency? She let her son take the first communion and telling me she's not a practicing Catholic and she's even a born again. I do not know where all these things fall to me.
For me, when I hear stories like that, I would accept more that it is a challenge that is given to us in the church. That there are many people who are hungry. There are many people who want to believe, who want to be challenged in the faith. And somehow we are not offering them the proper fare, the proper food. That's why we should offer them in the church. If people are looking for the Bible, give them the scriptures. We have the scriptures with us. But to be familiar with the scriptures. And even in catechism, you should tell them, show to them that we have the Bible. I also teach catechism even now as a bishop. I would ask our catechist in Tondo, I'm staying in Tondo, to give me classes. And I would teach mga 3 or 4 times a month. It's a grade 2, it's a grade 3, grade 6, my catechism. But I always make it a point in every class, may dala akong Bible. May dala akong Bible. And in every class, I always make it a point that I read the Bible to them. In order to make them see that my teaching is coming from the Bible. You cannot go to a catechism class na may lesson plan lang kayo. No, dapat may Bible kayo and make an opportunity that you have a special reading. Make them stand, make them sit properly because you read the Bible. No, that to show that what you are teaching flows from the Bible. Flows from the Bible. Get it?
Isuplan
lang dala. And then I'm going to bring the Bible and to show to them that you are reading from there. It flows from there.
Nagbasa po sa cellphone.
Ha? Kaya mga bata, they don't still realize a cellphone as a source of the Bible. Kailan lang libro? Okay? Yes.
Katapista po ako ni Sir Light. Tanong ko lang po. Kasi I was just wondering, kung si Lord Jesus ay buhay sa panahon natin ngayon, meron tayong mga Jewish sa church, tapos dito itong Roman Catholic na in-establish na. So, sa palagay niyo po, ano po ang masasabi nyo?
But our belief is if Jesus has founded our church and if we are true to him, I think he should come to us. He would come to us. Ang tanong nang, will we be able to recognize him? Because if he would come in our time now in the human flesh, probably he would come not as a priest. He would not come as a bishop. No. He might come as a stray child. Even he might come as a katutubo. Will we recognize him? No? Before we continue, may isang pagtanong dito, may isang kamay pa, yes.
I'm just confused kasi po 3 years ago pa lang ako nababaptis mo man as Catholic. Pero since birth, since na namulat ako, akala ko kasi Katoliko talaga ako. Kasi every time po na tinatanong mo yung parents ko, are we Roman Catholic? Yes. Kaya lang nagtaka ako nung pumasok na ako sa Catholic school, nagaan na ako ng college. Kasi yung kailangan kasi yung may confirmation, so kailangan ko ipapresent yung baptismal ko. Then nung tinignan ni Bishop yung baptismal ko, yung nakalagay na nagbinya sa akin is Reverend then pangalan ng babae. It's anonymous. Then tumawa sila, sabi nila, oh really, is this your baptismal certificate? Oh yes, Bishop. Tapos na po, ako nun akong pila. Tapos nalaman nila na invalid. Sabi na, oh how come na Reverend, tapos babae yung nandun. Tapos yun yung nagbinyag sa'yo. Sabi ko, naalala ko pa po yung mukha niya. Kasi palagi siyang pumupunta sa amin. Kasi every time na fiesta ng aming Our Lady of Manawag kasi doon sa chapel namin. Siya yung talagang nagbibinyag siya. Siya yung nagbibisa. Opo, nagbibisa. Siya babae po na nagsisipan. Opo, babae po nagsisipan.
Kasi Father, because she was in danger of death maybe, di ba? For the baptism, even the danger of death.
Umiyak talaga ako sa
baptism. Even the lay people can baptize. Maybe she baptized her in that.
Sabi ko, yes, mami ko sa grocery. Bata pa lang ako, sabi ko, train na nila ako. Sabi ko, wow. Tapos hindi pa nakaka.
But she wrote, but it should enter in the registry, di ba? Even though she was baptized. Eh, reverend.
Sabi ko, ano po ba talaga kayo na mag-misa? Kasi parang may question na sa akin eh. Kasi ako yung nagasigaso ng chapel namin. May fiesta ako lahat yung magmamanage. And then parang nung pag-novena, sabi ko, katuloy ko ba talaga yung binasukan ko? Kasi pag nandun ako sa Masbate, yes, alam ko Katoliko ako. Sinusunod ko yung mga anong Katoliko. Pero pagbalik ko sa amin, yun pa rin. Yung chapel namin doon, ako pa rin yung mamanage. Pero yung tanong kasi sa akin, pag ngayon nga, fiesta sa amin, May 4, Our Lady of Manawag, andun na naman siya nag-inisa. Kasi